Houston Station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, your weekly look at what's happening on board the International Space Station. I'm Amiko Cowder. The space station crew is set to capture a dragon. SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket with the Dragon resupply ship atop is set to lift off from Cape Canaveral, Florida on Saturday at 2:14 a.m. Eastern. The craft is loaded with more than 5,000 pounds of supplies and science experiments for the station. Flight engineers Reid Wiseman and Alexander Gerst refreshed their robotic skills this week in advance of Dragon's arrival and capture on Monday. And arriving aboard Dragon is a piece of equipment that may transform the station into a working machine shop. It's the first ever 3D printer flown in space. The printer works by extruding heated plastic, which then builds layer upon layer to create three-dimensional objects, so that critical missing bolt may no longer require a wait for the next resupply ship to be replaced. Instead, the part could be manufactured in space. This capability could decrease cost and risk on the station by creating on-demand supply for tools and parts. As the three current station residents continue their work in space, the other half of the Expedition 41 crew is preparing to join them. NASA astronaut Barry Wilmore and cosmonauts Alexander Samokutyayev and Elena Sarova traveled to the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan last week to complete final preparations for their launch to the station on September 25th at 4:25 p.m. Eastern aboard their Soyuz spacecraft. After a six-hour trek to the orbiting complex, the Soyuz will dock to the station's POIS module, and its three crew members will spend nearly 6 months living and working in space. This week's social media question is, how do the docking ports on the ISS prevent leakage? Rubber or plastics would get brittle in space, right? Well, that's true. Rubber and plastic would degrade in space over a long period of time, and the ISS has been flying for nearly 16 years. So the rubber seals that prevent leakage at the docking ports are attached to the visiting vehicles rather than the station. This prevents the material from being exposed to the harsh environment of space for too long. Make sure to keep sending us your questions and comments using the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.